So we have seen that the duplication of all the register values that have all and ever been produced is a problem. So we will look at register renaming, which is another scheme that can provide relief from false dependencies, but in a way that actually is more manageable. How does the register renaming work? So register renaming separates the concept of architectural registers, which are the registers that the programmers and the compilers use. So this is when you write an instruction like add R1, R2, R3, the R1, R2, and R3 that you're referring to are the architectural registers. In register renaming, there is also a concept of physical registers, which is all the places that we can actually put a value in the processor. So there is, of course, a place for kind of the latest value of R1, for example, but there could be additional places where we could potentially store values that should be going to R1. And then what we do is, as the processor reads instructions and figures out which registers they're using, and remember the program is referring to architecture registers, as it's fetching instructions and decoding them, it also does register renaming, which pretty much means that it rewrites the program to use the physical registers. So basically, if it sees add R1, R2, R3, it's going to rename that into, you know, add R something else, and so on, in order to basically refer to the places where it has actually put those values. And how does it know where the values are? Well, it uses a table called Register Allocation Table, or RAT. And you should remember this because we will be very frequently referring to the RAT because it's used very, very often. What the RAT is a table that says which physical registers has the value for which architectural register. So for each of the architectural registers, there will be an entry in this table, and it will say what is the current location in the physical registers where the value for that architectural registers can be found.